Spirit, Father. We thank you, oh God, for your Spirit. We thank you, oh God, in the name of Jesus, for your joy. We thank you, oh Lord, in the name of Jesus, for your love. We thank you, oh Lord, for your peace, Lord. We thank you all today, God, because you've been very good to us, Lord. Hallelujah. We thank you, oh Lord, for being perfect in all your ways, Lord. We thank you, oh Lord, in the name of Jesus, oh God. Hallelujah, for, oh God, walking amongst us, oh God, in the name of Jesus, with your arms, Father. We thank you, oh Lord, in the name of Jesus, Father God, for so loving us, oh God, that you died for us, oh Lord. We thank you, oh Lord, in the name of Jesus, oh God, how you for rising on the third day, oh God. That means that no grave can hold you, hallelujah, that the dead can't hold you, oh Lord. How we thank you, oh Lord, in the name of Jesus, that you still raise us. Hallelujah, we thank you, oh Lord, in the name of Jesus, that our minds is renewed, Father. In the name of Jesus, our mind belongs to you, Father. On this day, oh Lord, in the name of Jesus, we thank you, oh Lord. Hallelujah, on this day, oh God, we serve you, oh Lord. In the name of Jesus, in this house, oh God, we will praise you, oh God. We will rejoice, hallelujah. Oh God, we will be glad in it, Father. Hallelujah, this house is yours, Father. Our minds is yours, Father. Our hearts belong to you, Father. In the name of Jesus, our soul belongs to you. In the name of Jesus, oh God, there is nothing that can separate us. In the mighty name of Jesus, oh hallelujah, we thank you, oh God, in the name of Jesus, oh God, for you being Jehovah Jireh, which is our provider. Oh God, you are Jehovah Nissi, oh hallelujah, you are our peacemaker. Oh God, you are the way maker. In the name of Jesus, oh God, you are our source, oh God. In the name of Jesus, we plug into you, Father. You give us energy, oh Lord. Hallelujah, oh God, hallelujah. We thank you, oh Lord, for your mercy that endures forever. Your grace, oh Lord, in the name of Jesus. Oh God, we thank you, oh God, in the name of Jesus. There is no one like you. There is no one like you. In the name of Jesus, I can go to the highest mountain and I can't find nobody like you. Oh God, I can look around and I can't find no one like you. In the name of Jesus, oh God, there is no one like you. In the name of Jesus, my mother, my father, my family is nothing like you. In the name of Jesus, but I thank you, oh God, for being God and God alone. In the name of Jesus, I thank you, oh God, for my church family. I thank you, oh Lord, there is peace in this house. I thank you, oh Lord, there is love in this house. I thank you, oh Lord, there is joy in this house. Oh God, I thank you, in the name of Jesus, that you are in the place on tonight. Oh God, we will rejoice. We will rejoice. We will rejoice, because there is no chains holding us. In the name of Jesus, there is no mountain in our way. In the name of Jesus, oh hallelujah, there is fire of the Holy Ghost in this place. Oh hallelujah, there is God in this place. The Creator is in this place. God, we thank you, oh God, we thank you. In the name of Jesus, for being in the place one more time, God. We thank you, oh God, for giving us eyes we can see, Lord. In the name of Jesus, ears that we can hear. Oh, Lord, you said they have ears, let them hear. In the mighty name of Jesus. Oh, God, we thank you, oh God, in the name of Jesus, that we will sing unto the heavens. In the name of Jesus, we will praise with the angels. Hallelujah. We will rejoice with the angels. In the name of Jesus, we will sing holy, holy is our God. Holy, holy, holy. In the name of Jesus. Oh, hallelujah. I thank you, oh Lord, for your righteousness. I thank you, oh Lord, in the name of Jesus, for your holiness. I thank you, oh Lord, in the name of Jesus, for opening up the floodgates of heaven and pouring us out a blessing, pouring us out a miracle, pouring us out, oh God. Hallelujah. Your Spirit, God. You said that you would pour out
your spirit on all flesh in the name of Jesus, where young men will see dreams and old men will see visions in the name of Jesus. Oh God, we are the church of the 21st century. Oh God, hallelujah. How we will celebrate your name, God, in this place in the name of Jesus, because you deserve it, oh God. You deserve the praise. You deserve the glory. You deserve the worship. Oh God, you've been good. How you didn't let us die on our deathbed. Oh God, but you woke us up this morning. Oh God, you started us on our way, oh Lord, in the mighty name of Jesus. Oh God, hallelujah. You didn't let us close our eyes in the name of Jesus to death, oh Lord. But God, you gave us everlasting life. In the name of Jesus, we will praise you. We will honor you, oh Lord. Hallelujah, because you are God. You are our God. You are our Lord. You are our Savior. In the name of Jesus, we thank you, oh God. In the name of Jesus, forbid just that, Father. Hallelujah. We thank you, oh God, for our leaders, Father. In the name of Jesus, hallelujah. Been in the place, oh God. In the name of Jesus, hallelujah. We thank you, oh God, hallelujah, for the messenger. Hallelujah, and the message, Father. Hallelujah, we thank you, oh God, for breath, oh Lord. That meat, in the name of Jesus. We thank you, oh Lord. In the name of Jesus, that we no longer have milk, oh God. But we have meat, oh God, in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. We thank you, oh God, for that message being so strong, for that message being so powerful, in the name of Jesus. We thank you, oh Lord, in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Oh God, that your word, oh God, is life. In the name of Jesus, we thank you, oh God, for breathing on my pastor. In the name of Jesus, hiding him behind the cross, Father. In the name of Jesus, I thank you, oh Lord, that everything that he speaks, oh God, it will be you, oh God. In the name of Jesus, we thank you, oh God. In the name of Jesus, hallelujah. Oh God, was already birthed in his belly, oh God. In the name of Jesus, we thank you, oh God. In the name of Jesus, for that message, Father. In advance, Father. We thank you, oh God, for the praising, Father. In the name of Jesus, as they sing unto heaven. In the name of Jesus, hallelujah. As they rejoice, Father. Hallelujah. Touch their voices. Touch their stomach, oh God. In the mighty name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Let it be praise like never before. Hallelujah. I want to see people on their feet, Father, rejoicing with them. In the mighty name of Jesus, we pray. Amen.
Amen. Come on and praise the Lord. Amen. Come on and praise the Lord if you know that he is a good God. Amen. Come on. Doesn't the Lord deserve a thank you?
Thank you.
Come on. Somebody open up your mouth and tell the Lord thank you. Come on. Tell him thank you. Hallelujah. He didn't have to do it, but he did, and he is so great. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Bless the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. We bless the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. We are grateful
Lord.
People today, right?
Grateful,
hallelujah.
Grateful.
Oh, we will say thank you, Lord. Yes,
thank
Lord.
You, Lord.
Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Let's go. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Glory to the Lord. Hallelujah.
Bless the Lord. Bless the Lord. Bless
hallelujah.
The Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Thank you.
Hallelujah.
Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord.
Come on, open up your mouth and praise the Lord if you truly thank Him. Amen. Come on, start thanking Him right now. Shift the atmosphere and start thanking the Lord. Thank you, Lord, for my life. Come on, thank you, Lord, for my soul. Come on, thank you, Lord, for saving me. Come on, somebody open up your mouth and thank Him. Hallelujah, thank Him. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Come on, we praise the Lord and we just want to offer praise. It's what I do, amen. Hallelujah. Come on, let's praise the Lord. Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord. It's what I do.
Come on now, can we open up our mouth and praise God tonight? Come on. I think we can do just a little bit more better than that. Let's not sing the song if we ain't gonna do it. Come on, open up your mouth in the room and give him praise in the room. Come on, everybody, let everything that has breath in here open up your mouth and shout unto God with the voice of triumph. Come on, from the rising of the sun to the going down of the same, the name of the Lord shall be praised. Come on, Zion, let's bless our Creator. Open up your mouth and give him glory. Praise is what we do. Come on, Zion, I feel God right here. I said, come on, come on, we give you glory, we give you honor, we give you praise, we magnify you, we extol you. Nobody like our God. Praise is what you created us to do, and we come to do it tonight. I said, we come to do it tonight. I said, we come to do it tonight. Let all of the earth worship him. Let all of the earth worship him. I feel a ship right here, Izzy. I feel something stirring up. I said, I feel a ship. Come on, Zion. Let's bless him tonight. I said, let's bless him tonight. Let's bless him tonight. Hallelujah. I said, hallelujah to God. I said, hallelujah to God. I said, hallelujah. Come on, Zion. I said, hallelujah, hallelujah. Praise is what we do. The Bible says praise is comely for the upright. Come on, open up your mouth, righteous people, and give our God glory. I feel a shift right here. I said, come on and worship him. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Mighty is our God. I said, mighty is our God. I said, mighty is our God. I feel revival. Mighty is our God. Yes, Lord. Hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah. Come on, put your hands together one more time for our God. Come on, clap him like you really love him tonight. Come on. Hallelujah. We welcome you tonight to Boot Camp Bible Study. We welcome you to Basic Ministries. I'm so pleased and honored to say that our visionary and leader is none other than Pastor Mustafa. Can we celebrate our leader tonight? Come on, let's, or we can do better than that. Let's celebrate our pastor tonight. And we celebrate God for the fragrance of this house. Our first lady, we love her. Let's celebrate Lady Nell tonight. Hallelujah. Come on and clap it up for yourself tonight. Hallelujah. I said, you can clap it up for yourself better than that. Come on, clap it up for yourself tonight. Let us read and recite our mission statement. Basic Ministry exists as the church of the 21st century to help, heal, empower, lead, and prosper God's people and their community in order to bring glory. I feel the Holy Ghost to our Father. Hallelujah. Yes, Lord. In order to bring glory to our Father, which is in heaven. Why do we exist, Basic? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. For we know that God is a spirit, and where does he live? Do me a favor. Go greet somebody that you did not come to church with and just give them some godly love tonight. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Let's put our hands together. It is time for our basic news. Hallelujah. It's time for our basic news. Hallelujah. Let's remember that a scripture a day would definitely keep the devil away. This week, we are in Nehemiah chapter number 4 through chapter number 9. Again, we are in Nehemiah chapter number 4 through chapter number 9. Amen. So let's make sure that we're reading our scriptures. First Fruits with Pastor Moo every Monday through Friday, starting promptly at 7 a.m. live on Zoom. We are in prayer and intercession here at Basic Ministers. Join us every Monday through Friday, starting at 7 o'clock a.m. Amen. Amen. I am happy, amen, that Feed My Sheep is back. Come on, let's clap our hands up for that. And so far, just in 2 weeks, God has blessed us to feed 327 families here at Basic Ministries. And we're so excited, amen, about what the Lord is doing. Can we clap our hands up for Minister Alec, who's doing, as the old mothers of the church would say, a bumper job. And the Feed My Sheep staff, amen. We thank God for our staff. We feed here every Wednesday, starting promptly, setting up at 12 noon. And we start distributing groceries at 2 o'clock p.m. If you would like to be a part of this awesome ministry, please make sure that you tap in with Minister Alex. Or if you need groceries, you can come here every Wednesday and grocery shop right here at Basic Ministries. Amen. I'm excited that our pastor is in a new Bible study series about the fruit of the Holy Spirit. Anybody has been enjoying it? We're taking a little break, amen, but we're coming back, amen. So we're so excited about this. This has been an awesome, awesome series. Brothers and sisters, please do turn in your homework if you have not already. Please make sure that you do that, amen. We know that we have homework every week for each fruit, amen. So please make sure that you turn that in, amen. I'm excited that we are a church that believes in what? Come on, we believe in what? Amen. God bless you, Jakari. That means everybody got to do something here at Basic Ministry. Amen. As Pastor says, we don't have any cheerleaders. We all get in the game here at Basic Ministries. We have a plethora of auxiliaries, amen, that you can sign up for, amen. And if you would like to get acclimated, which you should be getting acclimated into a ministry, please make sure that you see me and I will point you into the right direction. Amen, brothers and sisters, we are doing something. We are updating our database system. If you are not in our database system, we need you to get into it immediately, amen, amen. And the person that can help you with that is either Sister Shar or Deacon James, amen. So if you don't know nothing about our church app, amen, please make sure that you see Deacon James or Sister Shar so we can get you implemented into our new system, amen. This is our new form of communication that we're going to be using, amen. So a lot of updates that we have about the ministry, amen, we're going to start sending it through our church app. But we need to make sure that everybody is in our database, amen. Amen. I'm excited about Pastor's new series. Anybody enjoyed it this past Sunday? Amen. We're so excited. We're so excited about the new series. He is. Join us every Sunday here at 11:30 a.m. where our pastor is preaching the word of God and it's going down. Amen. Amen. The world changers. Amen. Sister Shanae is coming. Amen. With a special announcement about World Changers, our first meeting this Saturday.
Hey, y'all. Hey. So this Saturday is our first gather, right? World Changes! Back to business. This Saturday is our first gathering. It's going to be at Round 1. And I need y'all to sign up. You, Jakari, I need you to sign up. I need you to, if you know anybody, if you have any kids here, please have them sign up. Reach out to me. I'm always around somewhere. We're going to be going to Round 1. We're going to be meeting here on Saturday at 6 o'clock. Jess, you coming? Okay. We're going to be meeting here at 6 o'clock. You coming, Nick? Amen. We're going to be meeting here at 6 o'clock on Saturday, and we're going to be heading on to Hayward. But we need to know, we need to have a head count of everybody that's coming so we can have rides arranged and we can know how many people we're going to have, right? So I'm excited, and honestly, I'm going to have fun. So when you come, I pray you come excited and ready to have fun, right? So yeah, we ready to go. So let me know if you coming so we can make arrangements for you or your kids. Let me know. And love y'all. Ages 12 to 24. Amen.
Come on, let's put our hands together for the world changers. I'm excited, brothers and sisters, that this Sunday, amen, we will be doing our church family feud against One Way Assembly Church. Amen. In the city of Richmond, California. Amen. Amen. This will be happening at 4 o'clock p.m., brothers and sisters. So please make sure, amen, that if you would like to go to meet us there after our morning worship service, the address to this is 1350 Kelsey Street in Richmond, California. Again, that is 1350 Kelsey Street in Richmond, California. Amen. We have already assembled our team and we've been studying, so we are so excited. We're going down there with victory. Amen. So we're so excited about that. Amen. So join us. We need y'all. Even if you ain't playing, come on and y'all come on and root on us, root for us. Amen. So we're so excited. Prayer Partners is returning. I said root on us, root for us. Amen. Prayer Partners is returning. Amen. We're excited. I promise you that this Sunday you will have your assigned prayer partner. Amen. We just praying about who we want you to pray with. Amen. So be patient with us. Amen. As we get this list together. Hallelujah. Amen. I'm excited that we have our own clothing line right here at Basic Ministries. Amen. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Filthy Rags, we do have all of these things available today. Amen. You can see Lady Nail. Amen. And she got them things in her trunk. Amen. Like Master P in early 90s selling CDs out of his trunk. Amen. We are selling hoodies and crew necks. We have those available. Amen. Today. Amen. Please make sure that you see Lady Nail if you want to purchase one. I'm excited that Pastor Moon new single. We can clap better for our pastor. Listen, y'all, I got some news. I'm happy to report. I feel like a reporter. Amen. Amen. Y'all know that our pastor, amen, the Lord has graced us, amen, to make history on Thizzler, which is a secular, amen, social media site on Instagram, right? Amen. And by the grace of God, listen, two things I want to announce. Pastor has got over 100,000 views on his clip. Come on, can we clap up? Oh, I think we can be just a little bit more excited about the kingdom of God being advanced. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. And listen, amen, and we just got the report, amen, for this week, right? And the most views, Pastor is at number 2 out of all of the posts. He's at, what? He's at 100,000. You got to add about 90 more on that, amen? But you all right. Keep counting. Hallelujah. But listen, amen. They just did the report, amen, of all of the most views and likes this week, amen, that is on Thizzler. And Pastor's post is number 2, y'all. Amen. Oh, come on. We can be excited. Now, listen. Now, when they first posted it, listen, I commented. But I'm going back to comment just to add some more comments on there. I need y'all to all just act like you didn't comment the first time and go right back on there and say, Pastor, I just now seen this. Amen. Amen. We want to make sure. Amen. Amen. Not we just support our pastor, but listen, this is on a secular site. Listen, people of God. And God is allowing us, amen, as pastors say, to bring the gospel to the gutter. Amen. So we're so excited about that. You said something, Pastor? What does number 2 mean, right? And biblically, like witness, right? So, and so as we know, brothers and sisters, amen, the Bible says, like, out of the mouth of every 2 or 3 witnesses, every word shall be established, right? Amen. So the fact, amen, that pastor is number 2, it really is symbolic, amen, that we're really witnessing and doing what God has called us to do. Literally, listen, on a secular platform. Y'all don't get it, amen. I'm excited, amen, about that. So let's make sure if you have not, brothers and sisters, go to the post and run it up.
I'm going to say this because I think this should be said, and this is be transparent. But I was leaving here, I think that was Monday, and I went to the gas station on my way. And unfortunately, it was a brother. I was at Oakland. I was going getting on the gas station. There was a brother, and he went to his trunk, and he was pulling from his trunk and putting in his car a big gun at the gas station. He just opened it with doing like this. And I'm looking like, okay. And he does like this. And he looks up and says, hey, man, I see you on business. And I said, wow, this is who you're reaching. This is who you're drawing. Are y'all listening to me? Now, that happened to me Monday. That this is who God is drawing. It is, or we're not doing music to be famous, to personally have a name. We can use this music as a language, amen, to preach the gospel through, to draw God's people to, amen. And that happened to me on Monday. And the Lord showed me, this is who I'm trying to draw. Are y'all listening to me? This is who I'm going after, amen. So to God be the glory. I just want to say that, amen.
Amen. Let's cap it up for our pastor. Let's look at his new video. Let's look at it real quickly. Amen.
Come on, everybody, let's all get down and just clap your hands to this funky sound. The priest in the booth with Simply Dre, so you know we gonna lift him up today.
I'm tired of being me, living my life like a creep. Pull up in my Jeep, I make my chopper go yeet. Posted on the corner, chilling with the villains, smoking marijuana. You see, I can't help myself. I'm bad for my health, about to kill myself. I'm fed up with myself, and I'm asking, can you save me, Lord, from myself? And make me just like you. Walk in, talk, and do what you do. Washed in your blood till I'm a see-through. Live life culture just like a Hebrew. Joined to the hip till they think what's I mean. Let your word be in me just like an IV. Identical like I stole your ID. Can't tell the difference if it's you or if it's me.
I gotta be just like you.
I gotta be just like you.
I gotta be just like you.
In everything I do,
every little thing, every
my Lord.
I gotta be just like you.
I gotta be just like you.
Like you.
Like. Y'all sing la la. Jeremiah.
Lord, I wanna be like.
Come on, let's clap it up, Pastor. And future in Jeremiah. Hallelujah. Amen. Please make sure that you go get Pastor New's single. I'm excited in the month of March we getting back to what we do best, and that is hit the block. Amen. Trap Ministries is returning in the month of March. Team Joshua, amen, on first Sundays. Team John the Baptist on third Sundays. Amen. If you do not see yourself on this list, please make sure that you see me so we can get you on one of these lists. Brothers and sisters, amen. We want to make sure, amen, that you are with us as we advance the kingdom of God and tell somebody about Jesus. Amen. 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 I'm excited, amen, about the mentorship program, amen, from my company. Amen. Amen. This is our second cohort. Amen. I'm going to teach, amen, this second cohort. Amen. I love Jakar today. You drunk your good juice today, huh? You ate your vegetables. Hallelujah. Amen. Our second cohort is starting on March 2nd. Amen. In 6 weeks, I'm going to teach you how to start and launch your business. Amen. Amen. So you do not want to miss this opportunity. Amen. It's going to be an awesome, awesome, awesome time. Amen. Amen. If you would like to be a part of this, amen, please make sure that you see me, or you can go to our website and sign up. Amen. Brothers and sisters, my Bible and my boombox is returning. Woo! With Emmanuel the prophet here right at Basic Ministries on April 21st, 2023. Amen. We want to make sure that we pack this place out. Amen. Amen. For those who have tickets, I said, what did I say? April 1st. I'm thinking about the tour. April 1st. Amen. We're excited. Amen. It'll be right here at Basic Ministries. For those who are selling tickets, our deadline to turn in your monies in is the last Sunday in March. That is March 26th. Please make sure that we have our monies into, amen, Lady Nail. How many know it takes teamwork to make the dream work? Amen. So we need to make sure that we pack this place out. Amen. Pastor is going on tour. Amen. In the month of April. So many great things is happening. Let's take a quick look at this clip about see where Pastor is going.
familiar with defeat. Not down, but fear did not keep me from getting up when I fall again. I just put the cycle on repeat.
Faith up in God till my life is over, ay.
I done been everywhere that you trying to go. So take a seat, son, and enjoy the show. I dipped my hand in gold, then I rolled the dice. It came back in folds, now it's on tonight.
Point to the hip till they think what's out of me.
Let your word be in me just like an IV.
Identical like I stole your ID. Can't tell the difference if it's you or if it's me.
Visions in my mind, thoughts suicidal. Back and forth to prison, I need to break this cycle. Incarcerated, agitated, felt I couldn't breathe. Gladiator school, or gangsters go to bleed.
Come on, let's clap it up. Amen. For the Against All Odds tour happening. Amen. In April. The dates are April.
Amen. Amen.
April. Amen. 21st. Amen. Pastor will be in Arizona. The 22nd will be in LA. And listen, on the 23rd, we'll be right here at Basic Ministries. Amen. Where we will end the tour. Now, brothers and sisters, please make sure that you mark on your calendar that day that we will not have service at 11:30. Amen. Pastor wants us all to be here at 6 o'clock p.m. Amen. To end the tour. Amen. Amen. So many great things happening in the month of April. I'm excited, brothers and sisters, about the return of our Dare to Dream program. Amen. This is our mentorship and internship program that we do for the youth in the city of Oakland. Amen. And we are doing great things. Amen. Last year was so wonderful. And again, we're going to do it this year. Amen. We're going to do it bigger and better. Amen. We do have a budget. Amen. That we will meet. Amen. And if you would like to help us meet that budget, amen, you can scan that QR code. Amen. And donate today. Amen. Or you can go to our website at www.jointhethamovement.com. Amen. These are our announcements. Let's clap it up for our announcements. Amen. Lady Nell is coming with Bible drill. Amen.
All right. All right. It's Bible drill time. I see we have some visitors in the building. Amen. We welcome our visitors. Reverend Wanda, God bless you. Amen. The way the Bible drill works is you need a real sword. A real sword, not a phone, not a tablet, a real sword. Get your Bible in the air. I'm going to yell out a scripture, and you have to find it while you're still sitting in your seat, right? Once you get to that scripture and that verse, you shout out, amen, stand up and read it. You got it? So I'ma yell out a scripture while you're sitting in your seat. You're gonna run to the scripture, that chapter, and that verse. Say amen and stand up and read it. Now we're very competitive here at Basic Ministry. So we have the lioness. Where my lioness at? Lioness, make some noise. Okay. And then we have our men's roll call. Men, where you at? All right. So we are very competitive here. We always think we're going to win, right, Lioness? All right. So here we go. One rule. You got to catch the beat. Y'all ready? Hold your Bibles in the air. You got to catch the beat. Bibles in the air. Crazy Bless, you playing? There you go. There you go. Hey, 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 hey. All right. First scripture. Somebody find Lamentations 1 and 2. Ooh. Did y'all know that was in there? Lamentations 1 and 2. Sit down, Alex. Lamentation. Mama Mary. Oh, amen. Amen. Mama got it. Ah, oh, you. Anybody got it? May got it. Lamentations. All right. Get your Bibles in the air. There is also a theme, so pay close attention to the scripture. Amen. Here we go, here we go. 2 Peter 3 and 4. 2 Peter 3 and 4.
Turn the beat up, over don't smile.
You can say I got the most. Say amen. You didn't say amen. Now, amen. Lioness. That's what I'm talking about. Get them up. Here we go. It's a new day. Do you hear me? It's a new day. Hello. It's a new day. Amen. Somebody find Isaiah 51 and 3. Isaiah 51 and 3. Hey! Amen. 3-0. I like this. All right. Get them up. Last one. Y'all ready? Somebody please find Mark 13 and 26. Hey! You flipping? No, Curtis got it. Curtis got it. Amen. Amen. Read it one more time for me, Crazy Bless. Read it one more time. Mark 13:26. Mm-hmm. Amen. What is tonight's theme?
No.
Out of all four of them scriptures, y'all didn't. Nobody know? No. It's coming. Coming. She said, duh. We ain't gonna be no duh.
Amen. Come on, let's give the Lord a round of applause. Amen. Amen. Good to be in the house of the Lord. Amen. Amen. Good to amen. See our visitors. Amen. We got Bishop Clark in the building. Amen. Let's give it up for Bishop Clark. God bless you, Bishop. Amen. 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 We're taking a pause, brothers and sisters, from our study regarding the fruits of the Spirit. Amen. One thing that's interesting, the fruit that we're going to be going into is patience. Amen. And while we're before we're studying patience, God is actually showing us how to be patient, because we were supposed to go over patience 2 weeks ago. No. Amen. But I had to be at Cal Berkeley, and now today we have, amen, special assignment, let me say a special teaching for us, amen, from Reverend Wanda tonight. Amen. But God is teaching us patience, because if you let patience have her perfect work, guess what? You'll be lacking nothing. Amen. And that's what God is doing, amen. He's making sure, amen, that his children are lacking nothing, amen. Tonight, brothers and sisters, what we're going to do, amen, because we are in partnership with the Oscar Grant Foundation, amen. And we're going to be doing a 10-week series, amen. So this is something we're going to be doing, I know for sure right now, every fourth Wednesday. And then me and Reverend Wanda are going to work out another day, amen. And this is about, this is with the Hope and Faith Wellness Group. Is that right, Reverend? Amen. And what this is about, brothers and sisters, is to make sure that the child of God is brought to wholeness. Amen. Mind, body, spirit, nutrition, finances, relationship, and more. Amen. Amen. So we're going to be, you're going to be having teaching, amen, from amen, Reverend Wanda, amen, every fourth Wednesday, and we're going to work out another date, amen. And this teaching is going to be around how God wants us whole.
Y'all understand that God wants you whole, amen? Amen. Whole in all things. Amen. Your spirit, amen. Your body, amen. Your finances, amen. Want you thinking right, amen. Acting right, being right, amen. Looking right. Are y'all listening to me, brothers and sisters? Amen. He wants us whole. Amen. So I'm thankful that we were able to enter into this partnership. Amen. Because even by us partnering and coming together, that's making us whole. Amen. Because she's going to be delivering something to us that's making us better. Amen. And I thank you because I don't have to do it. Amen. Amen. So I could take a break tonight. Amen. And sit and be fed. Amen. So I need you to, of course, tell our brothers and sisters, amen, that are not here tonight. Amen. Let's speak it up amongst, amen, our brothers and sisters, to let them know they definitely need to be here every Wednesday, but definitely also on fourth Wednesday. Amen. Trying to give you all I got. Is that all right, brothers and sisters? Trying to give you all I got. Amen. Amen. And the gifts to the body is to make sure the body is whole and strong. So at this moment, amen, I'm going to bring up our sister. Amen. This is the founder of Oscar Grant Foundation. Amen. A mighty woman of the Lord. Amen. Amen. And I always say this in her presence. Amen. Because, you know, God uses everything to teach us. God uses everything to teach us. Amen. Because God is in everything. He gave all things that exist existence. Amen. And so when I look at my sister and I know her story, amen, and I know what she's been through, the heartbreak we all have, amen, we all have seen, amen, and to see her continue to go forth and do ministry and feed the flock of God, amen, and even encourage others, one, lets me know that God can keep you through anything. Are y'all listening to me? There's nothing that God cannot keep you through. Amen. There's nothing that God can hold you through. And two, it shows me that you can turn, amen, your misery, your pain into your ministry. Amen. So the very thing that you're going through that's bringing you pain, God wants you to use it and turn it into your ministry. Because guess what? You're not the only one. Are y'all listening to me, brothers and sisters? There's other people that are going through what you're going through. There's other people, amen, that need you, amen. One way how you encourage yourself is that you encourage others, amen. So this is a model before us, amen. This is a model before us, amen, that God can keep us, he can sustain us, and God can, amen, turn our greatest pain, amen, to our ministry, amen. Amen. So I need you to give the Lord a round of applause for his vessel, amen. One of the gifts to the body of Christ. Amen. Reverend Wanda Johnson.
Now clap your hands for the Lord. Come on and clap your hands for the Lord. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Praise God. I first give honor to God and to the angel of this house, to the co-laborers, to Bishop Clark in the house. Praise God for you. What an honor to stand before you and just share. And so I have partnered with Pastor Mustafa talking and dealing with mental health. We don't talk about mental health in the church a lot. We hide mental health when our family members suffer with mental health. We don't want to tell nobody about it. When our family members are walking in the streets and talking to themselves, we don't want to tell anyone about it. When our family members are put away in Napa and John George, we don't want to tell anyone about that. We're embarrassed. We're a prideful people, so we wouldn't dare want anyone else to know that our family members are suffering with mental health challenges, or maybe we find ourselves suffering with mental health challenges. One of the things that struck me after my son was killed was to watch his friends deal with mental health challenges, Pastor Mustafa. When Oscar was killed, not only did it affect my family, but it affected those around. And from them being around, I watched them try to self-medicate themselves. I watched them try to use alcohol as their healer. I watched of us, many of our people do that on today. We find ourselves having these mental health challenges, and many of us say, don't go to the doctor. No, if you believe in God, you don't have to go to the doctor. But for me, Pat Bishop Clark, Pastor Mustafa, I say, get the help you need. If you need to see a psychiatrist, then go see the psychiatrist. Let down your pride and go do what you need to do to be whole. And oftentimes, when we think about it and we look at it, we don't want to let anyone else know the very things that we're going through when we're facing these mental health challenges. And so today, one of the things that I partnered up with NAMI, which is in Costa County, and I've also partnered with Peers, which is in Oakland, to talk about mental health in the churches. One of the things, and the reasons why I did it, because I know mental health is real. I have family members, close family members, who one day was normal, Pastor Mustafa, and then all of a sudden, they begin to see things, and they begin to hear things, and not knowing where it came from, but it evolved in them. And I always tell the youth on today that the weed, the marijuana, the cannabis that people are smoking today is different from the cannabis when I was growing up. When I was growing up, the cannabis, they would really just grow it in the ground and you'd smoke it, right? But today it's getting grown so fast under the heat lamps and the other chemicals that they put in it, which does something to our endorphins and causes people who have mental health challenges, it causes them to come out. And so we really have to look at the things that we're putting into our body that can trigger the very things that has been suppressed in us for years. And so I took on this assignment because I know that mental health challenges are real. And when we even look at the Bible, Saul was one who suffered from a mental health challenge. It said that David had to play for him to soothe his mind. And so when we look at mental health, we must understand that mental health is real. And so what we're going to do for the 9 sessions that we have, we're going to actually go through their material, but we're also going to look at scriptures throughout the 9 weeks. We're going to study the characters in the Bible, the men and women of God who suffered anxiety, who suffered depression, who suffered mental health challenges. And because we can look at the Bible, they are examples that, guess what? Mental health challenges is real. So when we look at mental health challenges, our first week, and it won't be tonight, but I just want to kind of lay the foundation of what we'll be going through. So our first session, we will talk about the stigma regarding mental health. When people deal with mental health problems, many people say, oh, they just crazy. You know, they just out of their mind. We say all kind of things which really internally goes into us. The scripture tells us that life and death is in the power of the tongue, right? And so sometimes we speak death unto others. Oh, they just crazy. They just out of their mind. They just on drugs. We say all kind of things, and they hear those things, and then guess what? They begin to believe those things, they suppress them, and then they walk those very things out. And so what we want to do is, our first session, is we want to talk about the stigma regarding mental illness. Where does it come from? What is its impact? What is internalized stigma? And what are the impacts and the self-reflections regarding internalized stigma? Have you ever had someone tell you maybe you're so ugly, and then you begin to believe that very thing? Those things are planted. So words hurt, even though they say sticks and stones may break my bones, but words will never hurt me. Words hurt, and sometimes we internalize those words. We still remember some of the words from, at least I do, because I'm kind of older than most of you in here. We still remember some of the words from 30 years ago. When I was in the fifth grade, I still remember some of the words that was said to me that wasn't so nice, right? And so we sometimes say things, and then we internalize them, and we hold them in our hearts, even though sometimes we say, I forgive you for saying that. But guess what? The word that was planted is still right there. And so we'll be talking about that kind of stigma. We'll be also talking in lesson two about the automatic thoughts. What are we thinking? The three C's, the strategy to change that thought process that we've been thinking concerning ourselves. Session three will be completing what we call a 3C strategy. And then session four, we'll talk about the strategies of strengthening yourself, the strategies of growing, the positive aspects of yourself that you may have put on the back burner due to mental illness or other challenges. You ever heard somebody say, you're not going to graduate from high school? And so you was already struggling in high school, and so guess what? You just went ahead and dropped out of high school. But you really wanted to complete it, but because words were spoken over your life that was negative words, you begin to internalize those very things, and then you believe them. And so we'll be talking about the importance of not allowing those negative thoughts to take root in us and to grow and manifest. We'll be talking about in session four the importance of strategies of strengthening ourselves, growing the positive aspects of yourself that you may have put on the back burner due to mental illness and other challenges. Session five, we'll be talking about increasing belonging, the importance of belonging and positive connections with others in staying strong. So there's times when our family members suffer mental health and we don't want to share it. We must understand their support groups. This is a session where when we talk and we share, you will have also the opportunity to share if you know someone, or to share, maybe it's you struggling with it, to be able to share in this safe space without anyone going outside saying, ooh, did you hear Sister Wanda? She said she had a mental challenge. But this, we make this a safe space in the house of God. Instead of us sharing what the other's going through, we begin to pray for each other. We love our brothers and sisters, so we encourage them. We pray for them. We support them in everything that they go through. That's what God is calling us to do. You know, that's why I love this ministry, because Pastor Mustafa is not only talking, but he's a man and a vision of action. And that's what we need in the communities in order for our communities to grow. We need less talk in the house of God, but more action. And so I watch on Facebook, and I watch your ministry out in the streets working to better the communities. And so that's action going. And so we'll be talking in session six, increased belonging. Again, the importance of us being together, the importance of us supporting one another through facing mental challenges, or family members facing mental challenges, because you are not alone. There's others that have to deal with family members who face mental challenges. And because of that, we can strengthen each other by sharing our story, by offering support to one another. Number seven, we'll talk about responding to stigma. We'll talk about the disrespect that people with mental challenges face. We'll talk about even us being disrespectful to them. Well, how could you be disrespectful when you walk by and say, oh, they just so stupid, or they're out of their mind? Well, that's being disrespectful to them. And so instead of us thinking about it that way, we have to learn how to begin to pray and how to begin to support them in whatever way that we can. You know, scripture talks about how even David ran into a cave and he was hiding. He talks about even how he had mental challenges. And so each one of us can face mental challenges. It's just how we handle it when we face it. What do we do about it? You know, how do we go forward? And then session 8, we'll talk about the course recap. We'll have a summary. And it will not just be me just talking, but this is going to be a group session where we can all, you know, share, where we can all participate and talk about the real, where we've seen so much homelessness. And it's not just because people just want to be homeless. Some are facing mental health challenges. You know, I could tell you one story. I have a cousin. I was walking, coming from the courthouse, and my cousin walked by me. And I didn't even realize that it was my cousin. But he walked by me, and then he saw me and said, "Hey, cuz." And I looked, and my cousin, he's homeless. He's not anymore, but he was homeless, right? Because he was facing some mental health challenges, right? And had we known, we would have tried to get him the help that he needed because his mother had passed away. And so I began to talk to him and talk to him to get into a place to help him. But I'm sharing that to say that because sometimes we don't want to talk about it. We know that our family member is out there, and we just go on, come to church, praise God. We know that Joe is on the street, out of his mind, and we're not trying to help him. But instead of us saying that he's out of his mind, we have to learn how to say a different word, that Joe is challenged. And because Joe is challenged, I'm going to do whatever I can to help Joe during his challenge that he's facing. See, because if we say, oh, Joe's just out of his mind, that's speaking negative about Joe, right? And so instead of speaking negative, we begin to turn around, okay, Joe's challenge. And what can Wanda do to help Joe? What could I do? Can I be there for Joe? Can I let Joe know, Joe, there's some places where you can go to get the treatment that you need if you want treatment? But there's certain ways, right, that we would say the very things to Joe. Because we wouldn't just say, Joe, you need to go to a treatment center and get the help you need, or Joe, you need to go check in John George. No, we begin to identify, and we have to put ourselves in Joe's position, right, and say, how would I want someone to help me during my crisis of mental health challenges? Because the truth of the matter, I don't know about you, but many of us have faced depression. And in the midst of that depression, guess what? A mental health breakout can come upon us, right, from that depression. There's people who have committed suicide because they was dealing with depression. And so when we think about mental health, we don't just think about schizophrenic, bipolar disorder, but we have to think about the whole thing in compass. And so the next thing we'll talk about is crafting an action plan of how to deal with the mental health sessions that we're dealing with. Any questions so far? Any comments? So my question to you, does anyone know in this room know someone who suffered mental health challenges? So almost all of us in here know someone personally who has suffered mental health challenges. So in them suffering the mental health challenges, What are some of the things that you may have heard about them said, or what are some of the things that you may have said about them while they have been going through? And this, we just being honest in here. So anyone want to share what they might have said about that person they know going through a mental health challenge?
Church actually has AA meetings daily, and where he's able to discuss what his habit and his heart is, you know, which is a major challenge for him because he doesn't even deny that he has a problem, you know. So he just started going. So the fact that he's going is a blessing. Tried to uplift her along throughout the year. You know, I've always told her, why don't you go and talk to somebody, talk to a therapist. But she doesn't. She's a doctor. You know, she keeps it all bottled in. You know, so I've just been praying. All I can do is just keep praying, right? So I see God working on her a little bit. You know,
so. And that's what a lot of us do, is internalize it. We don't want to share it. Why? Because we're prideful people, right? We don't want, you know, we don't want others to know, oh, I'm suffering a mental challenge, or I'm suffering a breakdown, or I'm depressed, you know, or I feel anxiety. We don't want others to know that. So we harbor it in, and then when we continue to internalize, it continues to grow within us. And so it gets worse and worse and worse. And that's why it's so important that even the family member talk about it, because it is a burden. It's I don't want to say a burden, but it's a hard load to carry when you have family members who face mental health challenges. And so because we often have family members or people that we know face the mental health challenges, we have to really look at, okay, what kind of mental health is my mind in too? That's why it's important for us to pray. That's why it's important for us to read the word. That's why it's important for us to worship. I couldn't help but when I was in here at during worship time and you guys were singing, I thought about, I believe it's in 2 Samuel, I thought about, I'll just share it with you, and I'll give you the scripture. I thought about how it is, I think 2 Samuel 6, how David had 30,000 men. They were going up to get the Ark of the Covenant. We know that the Ark of the Covenant means the presence of God. The Ark talks about the presence of God. They was going up to get the Ark of the Covenant. And as they went up, one of Uzzah, he touched the Ark the wrong way. And because he touched it the wrong way, he fell dead. Scripture says, Pastor Mustafa, that David got angry. He got angry. And when he got angry, then he didn't take the ark any further. He left it at Obed-Edom's house. And as he left it at Obed-Edom's house, Scripture also tells us that everything that Obed-Edom had was blessed. Okay? It said that everything that was assigned to Obed-Edom was blessed. When David heard about that, 3 months later, I believe it was, he went to go get the ark. Okay? As he went to get the ark, he would go a few spaces, and the musicians would play, and David would praise God. Right? So why am I saying this today? When we look at the very first part of that, where we see David got angry, many of our young men have seen so many things that we cannot imagine that they have internalized. And because they've internalized that anger internally can manifest itself in so many different ways. Many can get a gun and shoot somebody and not think about it. Many will end up in prison for doing all kind of things. But do you really know, if we really study our society, that many of our African American young men are in prison, but the ones that are in prison, they face a mental health challenge that has been untouched or unmedicated or unhealed, and they just go straight to prison instead of going to get the treatment that they need. And so this is why this session is so important to me, because we have to understand that sometimes our young men, they do things because they're crying out for help. And if we are not out there witnessing, if we're not out there sharing the gospel, when they're crying, they will end up in prison. You know, I think about my nephew has a mental challenge. And my sister and I was looking for him and looking for him and looking for him. So we said, well, we're going to call Santa Rita. And guess what? He was in Santa Rita, no medication, just there. Right? And so I'm saying that to say that there is a lot of untreated young men and young women walking around our neighborhoods ready to explode. And we walk by them every day and don't even say a word. We walk right by them where they need help. They might just need you to say hello to bring them back to right now. And we just go on by. And we always have the picture of the Good Samaritan. First, I want to finish with David. When David would take a few steps with the Ark of the Covenant, after he got over himself from being angry with God, it said that he praised God. It said that he would go a little bit further, and the musicians would play, and David would be dancing. Out of his mind, it said he danced so hard. And those around him, including his wife, was mad, Pastor Mustafa. She was mad. She wanted to know, was he out of his mind dancing like that in front of those women and those people? So why am I saying this on today? Because we are the people of God. I think as Peter tells us that, First Peter 2 and 9, that we are a royal priesthood. We are a holy nation. We are a peculiar people, right? So when we're out in the streets. We're in the world, but not of the world. And when we come across people who may be facing mental health challenges, we can share, you know, brother or sister, I love you today. But we walk right on by, and we act like, oh, they just out of their mind. That's what many of us say. Oh, they just on one. And we just keep right on going. But it's time for us to stop, to look, and to hear what God is telling us today. Because he's telling us that as we're witnesses, we're not only sharing the gospel, but we're witnessing by our lifestyle, we're witnessing by our praise, we're witnessing by our prayer, we're witnessing by that being that good Samaritan that God has called us to be. And so as we go through the course overview and as we go through the sessions, we will learn about mental illness in depth, and we will learn the very things that we need to learn to for us individually, internally, and for us to be able to help others externally. Because there are some things that we say to those that are suffering mental challenges that we may not need to say. They don't need to know, what, you crazy, you on drugs? They don't need to know that. But what they need to know is that, you know what, no matter what you're going through, brother or sister, God loves you. God loves you with an everlasting love. And with loving kindness, he will draw you. I can't draw you, but God can draw you. And that's what God is calling us to do. Sometimes we have to remember where we came from. We have to remember those things. And only and say, God, by the grace of God, I didn't get further into it than what I was in it. I never forget, Pastor Mustafa, when I was on 483 Darien Avenue, when I pulled up in the driveway. It was two guys shooting. All I could do was let the seat back. But I knew from that day, I said, God, if you get me out of this that I'm in, I'm going to serve you eternally. I never forget, Pastor Mustafa, I was outside standing in front of the house, and a couple of the young men that I knew at the time, I was talking, one had a gun, and the other one was like, shoot me, man, shoot me, shoot me, shoot me. And my other friend shot him. And I was right there looking, Pastor Mustafa. And you know what? The bullets don't have no name on them. And I'm saying all this to say that we have to remember what God has brought us through. And as we remember those things, I think about the scripture, this I recall to mind, therefore have I hope that the Lord's mercies are new every morning. And because of his mercies, because of what he's done in my life, I can't just walk by someone having a mental challenge and not offer them some type of hope. That's what God is calling us to do. And so we'll talk about the mental challenges that others face. We'll talk about what we can do to assist them as they're going through. We'll talk about the different stereotypes. We'll talk about the different self-conscious complexions. We'll talk about the different group identifications, because we want to group people and give them a diagnose, and we haven't even went and got the medical license. You know, we haven't figured out what's wrong with Sue over there, but we don't know what's internally what's wrong with us, but we could diagnose Sue. And so we'll look at all that. And I think as we finish this session, we'll have a greater understanding of what mental health is. We'll have a greater understanding of how we can help those who are facing mental health challenges. And we'll have a greater understanding of where they can go to get the support, and where we, if we want to support, to be in a support group, where we can go to get the support group, to join the support group as well. Any questions so far? I hope that this part is helping someone as we dive into the mental health sessions, because I believe, Pastor Mustafa, that the more that we learn concerning mental health, the greater we are when we get people who will come into the ministry that's facing a mental health challenge. You know, we want to say, we're going to cast the devil out of them, right? Now, that's what we used to say. I'm kind of older. So if somebody come in with a mental health challenge, they would be saying, oh, that's just a devil. And so we're going to cast that devil out of them. And it's not always a devil. So we'll learn how to deal with mental health challenge patients or people that will come into the ministry. We're not going to look down on them, but we'll love on them. We'll encourage them. We'll pray for them. We'll help and motivate them to get the help that they need to be able to deal in the society that we deal in. Because this ain't a fun society to deal with. You know, I never understood when Paul talked about to live is Christ and to die is gain. I was like, well, I want to be on earth for a long time. But the older I get, I'm like, God, I know you calling me home soon to get away from all this. But this is what we are called to do, to learn to be able to help those who are more challenged than we are, and even to help ourselves when we face the challenges that we face. Thank you.
Hallelujah. Come on, let's give it up. You guys ready for this journey? Amen. We're getting ready. Amen. We're getting ready for God's harvest. Amen. So we can really minister. Amen. And bring and help God. Amen. And let me say, allow God to use us to help transform his people. Amen. It is our job to make disciples. Amen. It is our job to bring God's people closer to him. And when Reverend Wanda was talking, I was thinking to myself, because I work in that environment with people with that are mentally challenged. Amen. I see it every day, all day. And there's one lady in particular who I see that every time, amen, often she's walking up the street talking to herself. But like Reverend Wanda said, I start just talking to her saying, I love you. I start saying, you my sister. And did you know, and then I start praying with her. And do you know every time she sees me, she stops and says, hey, brother, we gonna pray? Because I didn't look at her and say, oh, you crazy, get away from me. But I embraced her. I loved her with the love of Christ. And I literally can see her coming back. I keep telling her, you're gonna be a great witness for Jesus. We all gonna see what God gonna do with you. And I can see it happening. Amen. So we do have people in our community like this day that are God's sons and daughters. Amen. And we have to reach them. But the Bible tells us in 2 Timothy 1:7, for God has not given us the spirit of fear, but power, love, and amen. We need everybody in here with a sound mind. Yes, sir. Are y'all listening to me? We need you to have the right perception. We need you to be thinking right. Amen. We need you to be talking right. We need you in your sound mind. Are y'all listening to me, brothers and sisters? Amen. And this is good, because I don't think I've ever seen it in my time growing, so many people that's mentally challenged. You didn't see it like this, people just walking down the street talking, not and young. You're starting to see that more and more and more, because the enemy's attacking that right there. Amen? But we're going to equip ourselves, amen, to help our brothers and sisters. Amen. We exist to do what? Yeah. We exist to do what? Yeah. Amen. So we are equipping ourselves, amen, to help our brothers and sisters. So like I said, every fourth Wednesday, we're going to be going through this course, amen, and we will be preparing another day, amen, so at least it'll be twice, amen, a month, amen, that we're going to be going through this, equipping ourselves, amen, and preparing ourselves to help our brothers and sisters, as well as helping ourselves, amen, amen. So I know some documentation going around. Please make sure you sign and do what's needed, amen, for this course, because this is in partnership, amen, with Reverend Wanda Johnson, and I know the Alameda County and a couple of more people, amen. Amen. So we thank God for, amen, sending us help so that we can help. Amen. Amen. Any questions or comments, brothers and sisters? Amen. The Lord willing, if of course, worship Sunday we'll be in worship. Amen. And next Wednesday, Lord willing, we'll be going back to the fruits of the Holy Spirit. If you have not done your homework, amen, I need everyone to do their homework. That's to take the first three fruits that we've all already done. We have done. What's the fruits we've already covered? Love, joy, and peace. So, amen. We need your homework assignments turned in. Amen. And, lady, no, let's keep us accountable. Amen. Of doing that. Amen. And Lord willing, next Wednesday we'll be going into patience. Amen. Amen. But this is boot camp Bible study. I got to equip the soldiers. Amen. We're being equipped, amen, to do everything God has called us to do. Amen. Amen. Any questions or comments? Amen. Well, I'm going to let you, amen. We're going to pray. And then if you can, continue to fill out the paperwork that is needed. Amen. You guys ready to go through this journey? Amen. Amen. To God be the glory. Amen. Let us pray. Father, we thank you. We praise you. We honor you. And we glorify you right now, Master, in the name of Jesus, Father God. We thank you, Father God, for giving us a sound mind, Master, Father God. Hallelujah, Father God. Hallelujah. How do I know we have a sound mind, Lord? Because we have a symbol to bless your name, Father God. And there is nothing greater, Father God, than to praise and to bless your holy name, Father God. But I pray, Father God, for our brothers and sisters that are, Father God, suffering, Father God, mental challenges, Father God. I pray right now that you heal them, Father God. I pray that you, Father God, will give us the tools, Father God, that will help them, Father God, get to their healing, Father God. We want everybody, Lord, in our company, Father God, to be whole, Master, in the name of Jesus, Father God. We speak to our minds tonight, Lord, and we pray in the name of Jesus that we will think correctly, Father God. In the name of Jesus, we will not be worried. We will not have anxiety. We will not feel ill about ourselves, Father God. We will not, Father God, oppress ourselves with negative judgment from our heads, Father God, in the name of Jesus. But we are strong. We are mighty. We are children of the Most High God. We are a royal priesthood, a holy nation, a peculiar people, Lord, that have been put on this earth to show forth your glory. Father God, we are the sons and daughters of the Most High God, Master. Hallelujah. We carry, Father God, this heavenly treasure inside of us, Lord. We are somebody, Master, in the name of the Lord, Father God. I pray that everyone in here, Father God, will know that in their heads. They're somebody, Master. They're somebody. They're King's kids, Master, in the name of Jesus, Father God. They're loved by you. They're loved by heaven, Father God. They're loved by us, Master, in the name of Jesus. For you have not given us the spirit of fear, but you've given us power, love, and a sound mind, in the name of Jesus. Glorify you, we honor you, and we praise you, Father God. And we ask, Lord, Father God, that you anoint Reverend Wanda, Father God, to teach us, Father God, Lord. Use her, Father God, to prepare, Father God, your children, Father God, to do the work, Father God, that you're calling us to do, Father God. Equip us, Father God, to reap your harvest in the name of Jesus. Continue to bless, Father God, the Oscar Grant Foundation, Father God, and the ministry, Father God. Continue, Father God, to give them the strength, Father God, and the resources to fight for justice, Master, in the name of Jesus, Lord. And as we transition on our way home, Master, we ask that you give us traveling mercy and grace, Father God, in the name of Jesus. Let your people, Father God, experience your joy, Father God, in the name of Jesus. We give you the glory, we give you the honor, and we give you all the praise. It's in Jesus' mighty name we say and we pray together. Amen. Amen. Let's give God a round of applause. Amen. Let's give God a round of applause. If you have any questions, amen, please see, amen, Reverend Wanda, amen, regarding this journey, those papers, if you can please turn them in. amen to them. Amen. That'll be great. Amen. Let's tell brothers and sisters to be here on 4th Wednesday. Amen. And I'll be letting you know by this Sunday what's the next date so we can be announcing it to all of our brothers and sisters. Amen. Get your homework in. Amen. For next week, and we'll be studying the fruit of patience. Amen. I said, Lord, you're teaching us how to be patient before we get in it. Amen. To God be the glory. Amen.
It gets so hard, just trying to figure it out, fighting doubt, trying to believe God, trying to watch the words in my mouth and stay on.